Hi, welcome to the last session of the day. I hope you are not tired, and I have the difficult task of influencing you on open source. I call it a difficult task because WSO2 is all about open source, so there has to be one way or the other that you are convinced about open source too. That is why you are here, I suppose. So let me try and inspire you at my best on top of what you already know about open source. But anyway, most of the things that are there in this slide deck that I'm going to talk about might be quite familiar to you already. Nevertheless, I will try and emphasize the value of open source in general, as well as especially in the context of integration space and middleware space. So why you should bother about open source? One of the natural understandings is that it's cheap, so we should give it a try. I wouldn't like to call open source software to be cheap. I would call it low cost, but there are so many other values that brings in with open source, and that is why you should take open source seriously. So I have listed some of them here. One thing is that you can build an ecosystem around the kind of solutions that you and provide solution services that you are going to provide within your organization when you are a consumer of open source, because people who are trying to use your system when your system is using open source would be familiar with the APIs, programming techniques, exposed extension points, etc., because they are naturally already open in the community. And then it also allows you to easily build communities both within the organization as well as outside the organization when you try to expose them as APIs or other means of making sure that you are trying to let people integrate to your systems. And obviously, like I said, there's the cost advantage. And then the other aspect is the quality advantage. There are debates about whether open software is quality or not. But given the culture that is surrounding it, it naturally encourages high level of quality and innovation. So it is a fact that it gives you better quality. So the point is that better software is required for successful software projects and services within an organization, but it is not enough. And in order to transform your industry into the next level, and open source is not just about software, it is also about the value it brings into the ecosystem, and that is why you should be considering the open source aspect of your solution or the open source aspect of the products that you're going to use in order to build your solutions. So as I said, it's not only about the financial value. It is predominantly about the culture that is associated with open source, because the community-driven model encourages both respect and ethics within the community, so that that enables to bring the quality aspect and the security aspects into the open source product itself. And once you are using, you also get used to the community aspect, because you have to engage with the community, move along with the community, etc. And then thus make sure that you also become naturally part of the community aspect of the software that you are using. And then also the culture fosters innovation, and it opens up people's minds to discussion. It encourages open communication, and that basically makes sure that people are forced to innovate, forced to discuss ideas, and then that leads to natural innovation. And then the other aspect of open source is that overusing open source products for your solution, it also helps you to consider using open source as an engineering process. The methodology of development, methodology of collaboration that open source communities use can be used in turn within your organization, even though you might not be an open source organization, to develop software, because that helps making sure the qualities of open source software are brought into your project naturally within your organization as well. So I'm not talking about making your software open source, but rather using the open source process as an engineering process to build your solution within the organization. So things such as the collaboration, the familiarity of the technology across the teams that you are involved with, and then the crowdsourced quality so that people who are trying to use your software is testing it for you and enhances that you improve quality, etc., is an important aspect that can bring about by using the open source process itself in order to build your software system in-house. And then the other aspect is that is about the using the open source software process model to develop software for your organization, even though you might not be open sourcing your software projects that you have. Then the other aspect is that the open source as an organization model. If you look at almost all the open source software based foundations, they have a particular organization model which are basically based on open principles. And then which are which has a well-defined governance model, well-defined respect to the kind of contributions that may that people made. It encourages flexible organizational structure, so you can be influenced in order to run your organization using the open source model as an organizational model. So for example, WSURO is a great example of that. WSURO develops open source software, but at the same time, we are a business organization as well, where we run as a business too. But within the organization, what we practice is the open source organization model, so that we encourage everybody to be part of the equation, and then we give opportunities to anybody, even to interns, to be part of the system and encourage enhancements into the system. So it works really well as an organizational model too. So the economic value of open source comes from basically the labor economics. Most of the open source projects out there are sometimes contributed by people who are passionate about technology, and then they don't care about earning something out of it, but rather contributing. So there are some labor economic factors that comes into the picture. Then there are direct cost savings from the organizations that use the open source model. There are a lot of pricing flexibility. But then that's the financial sides of it. But then you also have non-direct cost related economic values from open source, especially the efficiency, how soon the community moves, how soon they innovate, how strategically they approach the system, which are all fostered by the open communication model, etc. And then you as an organization, which might not be doing open source, but you want to use open source, you as an organization, which you might not develop open source, but you want to use open source, you can get into the open source projects and communities, and then start taking control over the communities, start making influences over the communities, etc. So if you compare your ability to influence a proprietary vendor versus an open source vendor, you have more control, or you have more reach in terms of influencing an open source based vendor as opposed to a proprietary vendor, because the model is encouraging you to come and engage at various levels, right? So that is an important economic aspect, because it is not about building something today, it is also about making sure that you have a sustained solution for the future. So when you look at the future of your solution and how to make sure that in the future you are covered to be not only profitable but to be secure in terms of a solution, that making sure to be able to take control of where the project is directing, or at least being able to influence where the project is heading, is an important factor that you have to take into account. And that is especially important if you are going to bet your corporate strategy on open source based products. And in general, whatever the products you use, you might have to have some sensitivity in terms of how will this affect not only about implementing a solution today, but tomorrow, when the environment changes, would we still be able to survive with the kind of products that we are trying to use? So open source gives better economic value when it comes to having more control in terms of your solution over cost. the customer value of open source is, one thing is the ability to adapt is quite easy. You can make the process fully transparent. You can implement something fast, prototype without spending anything because it's open source at the end of the day. It's free to try, free to use, so that you have more spectrum to try out something and then also show the value that it could deliver. And people can more transparently look into what's happening in terms of what's going to happen. And also, there are other aspects such as the legal terms. What would be the legal terms, license agreements that you're going to adhere, that you have to adhere to when you're using something? And the value of open source is that most of the open source products are basically based on standard licensing models so that the corporate legal entities will be comfortable of using. For example, WSUD uses the Apache license. Any the legal department officer that we talk in terms of customers are familiar with the implications of using that. So it becomes easy to not to have surprises when it comes to addressing the legal aspects of using something when you have the legal terms which are very clear in terms of the licensing model, etc. And then it about in the morning. So if you have time to invest, open source is a great way. You can get your developers to get engaged in the community and try and develop something, or you can, even though you might not be contributing to the open source project itself, you will be able to get your developers to invest time and build a solution on top of that on their own, trying to figure out what is going on, etc., etc., and then maybe find bugs or complexities in the process and spend time to debug and try and figure out how to fix it. Some balance between being open source and being commercial. So this is ABC of IT. I'm not going to explain that. Basically, you need some hardware, you need some software, and you need some services in order to implement a solution in an enterprise. We all know hardware costs are relatively low as well as relatively constant. So if you try to save something out of the hardware, it is really difficult. Obviously, people go for these days cloud, etc., etc., but even at that, there's a limit that you can reduce the hardware cost to. Then comes the question of, if you want to save costs, where can you save costs? You could be able to save the costs in the software space or in the services space. What you can do is that, so the first project, if you look at, you have the constant hardware cost, on top of which you have the software cost, then you have to spend something on services. So provided that you go for an open source model, you might be able to cut your costs much lower level, making sure that your overall project cost goes down, or you can reinvest the saved cost into the project services itself and make sure that it is much more of quality or tested, etc. Or you can go for higher level quality of service providers, etc. Right? So the economic factor can drastically change with respect to your project. If you are money concerned, you can save a lot of money by going to open source. And if you are quality concerned, not only you can bring about the quality of the open source aspect, but you can also increase your quality aspect by spending more into services. So basically, it allows you to get to faster ROI if you reinvest, as well as have a better value proposition in terms of the overall project when you try to deploy it as a solution outside. And then the other aspect is that maybe you don't have much of open source in your solution. You can start small, try to replace some of the components. You don't have to go big bang when you try to go with open source. And obviously, given the, again, to reiterate the fact that you can try it for free, you can just try it and see whether it would work with you. And if not, you can throw it away, try different projects, et cetera, et cetera. So you have the room to play around when you have integrated stacks and try to gradually replace the expensive pieces with open source alternatives. And then the open source availability advantage is that you can download and play, you can build, help build the community, you can contribute back if you have the bandwidth to do so, and you can also explore and innovate because of the availability aspect that brings with open source. So basically, given that you have the ability to access it freely, it breaks the barrier to entry because, again, to reiterate, you can reduce the risk of failing because you can give it a try and have confidence. The cost will rise later if you go for support services, etc., for the same project, but that's later. That's later when the technology is proven to work. So once the technology is proven to work, it is easier for you to convince management that this is worth an investment rather than not knowing at the beginning whether it is a worth an investment and try and waste your money. And then you can build relationships too. For example, if you try to run a project, your developers, your architects are not convinced, you can ask them, this is the product that you can that we are going to use. You can go try it out. You can go explore it. You can go figure it out for yourself. So you can build trust on the technology. You can make sure that people are all informed about what the products that you are going to use all about. There's nothing hidden. And then you can encourage collaboration. And then you can demonstrate the value before jumping into the use of the particular product that you are trying to use. And then the other aspect is that you can also use open source as a recruiting vehicle. If you are using a top open source known technology, you can attract the skills around that. And also by making sure that you work with the community, you can get to know who are the key players in the community, etc., and you might want to recruit them as employees into your organization so that both you get influencing power on the project as well as you get very good technical capabilities into your organization. So when it comes to contributing to the project and influencing, there are three dimensions that you can get engaged with. You can contribute as a user, you can ask questions, that adds to the knowledge base. You can answer questions, that adds to the knowledge base. And then you can start contributing if you figure out bugs, if your developers, etc., in the project that you are working with are capable of fixing some of the stuff, you can go back to the community and contribute. And then you can, when you contribute more, you can become committers. And committers are the people who have the decision-making power in most of the open source projects. Now you have influencing power on the project. So that's the strategy to start contributing, gradually go into influencing mode into the project, right? So it makes it easy to be part of it and also be able to influence the direction where the project is going. And then the other aspect is brand value, right? So when you try to compete with large brands and IBM and Oracle, and when the alternative solutions are from those brands, if you can bring another brand, open source also have equivalent brand value. So you can come up with an open source alternative and fight with those brands and say that, okay, this is as good as these other solutions from this particular vendor, right? And then it is also a known fact that in the industry space, the wave of disruption is driven by open source aspects. The best example, as discussed by Isabel in the morning, is the big data space. Most of the projects and innovation has happened around open source projects, right? So open source has a big say in that particular arena, right? And then the other factor is that, okay, you're trying to suggest something from open source. If there's resistance, how can you fight it? And then it's increasingly becoming the default. This is a summary of the one of the surveys reports that came into 2015. 78% is saying they're using open source in their operations. 66% is saying open source is their first tryout option when you try to start a new project. 64% of the companies are participating in open source so that they can influence. So they are going towards the influencing factor. And 55% of the people believe that open source has better security because of the cultural aspect that I described, right? So it's not something new. A few years ago, it was a battle to convince people that open source is good enough, you should give it a try. Now it's a no-go, it's a given, it's the default. Majority of the people are believing in the space. So if you are an open source champion, the chances of you becoming successful is higher now compared to a few years ago. So that's good news if you are an open source champion within your organization. And then some of the insights in terms of what our customers are doing. Most of the customers are developing policies, for example, saying that if you're trying to go with a new project, our first evaluation would be on based on an open source based project. We will not preclude open source from our solution strategy, but it will be included. So if you're trying to build a proposal, you have to include open source into the equation, and so on. So establishing organizational policies that deals with open source is becoming key and we have noticed that with our customers. And then the other aspect is that some customers are developing transition strategies. Yes, we are predominantly proprietary right now. However, our future solutions will be more biased towards open source. And this is the strategy that we will take in order to transition. We will give it a try first. We will evaluate the options. We will make it a partial run. Some components will be replaced with open source and then move ahead, right? And then the other aspect is that people, especially if your solution is strategically important for the organization, they love to work with the vendors to influence the vendors in terms of where the future is heading. So from that, customers are looking from a collaborative perspective. How can we work with our vendor so that not only we get a good solution today, but we will get a good solution 3 years, 4 years, 5 years down the line so that we can retain this upward technology strategy within the organization by making sure that we have a collaboration with the vendors kind of scenario. So those are some of the things that our customers are doing in the open source state, open source space when it comes to strategic moves. That's all I had. Thank you, slide is missing. Thank you for your time. I think it is time to start with reception. Thank you.